Hi everyone, today I'm going to be showing you my must-have 2013 products. It's not all going to be like the best foundation or the best blush. It's actually going to be a few foundations, a few blushes, a few skincare products and so on. So don't forget to leave me a comment. Tell me what are your favorite skincare products, makeup products. Leave a comment below. I would love to try a few new things. Don't forget to like this video and share it with your friends if you do like it. And now let's get down to my most loved products. Alright, so first thing I'm going to talk about is the eyes. I actually have three eye products that I want to mention. High end is Dermalogica, the Intense Eye Repair. Works amazing. I use it from time to time. The Vitamin E Body Shop product, which I've been using long time, really good with puffiness. So if you have clients that are puffy, this actually works amazing on them. And recently I started using, it's called Rehydra, and you can't see because of light. It's basically from an Italian brand called Visaggi. I'm not sure how to pronounce this. The name will be somewhere here on the screen. Don't forget to open my info box below the video. There will be a link to my blog post with all the details to what products I'm mentioning in the exact order. As time is passing by, my skin underneath my eyes is very dehydrated, so I'm starting to more and more prefer my Dermalogica one or the one from this Italian brand. Both are excellent. The next thing I'm going to talk about is my face. For removing makeup, I like to use, of course, normal cotton swabs. I love to use this. This is a baby wipe, and it's from the drugstore in Europe called DM, and it's called Baby Love. It's amazing. And I also love to use, I prefer this one more than my Biodermal one. It's called the BioPharm Natural, and I love it. It's excellent. For removing makeup from my eyes, I love to use Nivea's Double Effect Eye Makeup Remover for sensitive eyes. If you have contacts, I do recommend this one. It usually has like a clear fluid and this blue fluid, and you just mix it up, and it gets kind of this kind of mixed shade, and then you take off your makeup. Excellent for removing waterproof makeup. Now the creams that I use, I started recently using John Masters Organic Bearberry Oil Skin Balance Serum. I'm in love with this. I recently started using it, so I'm going to be talking about it in my upcoming skincare routine. Another product I like using, so I use these all three, but not like at the same time. One day I'm using one day I'm using the other one, is my Dermalogica Ultra Calming Serum Concentrate. If my skin is extremely irritated and sensitive, I like using this one. And if I feel like during winter time that my skin's feeling extremely dry, then I like to use my Hydrolon. I don't know how to pronounce this, but this product is also excellent. So those are the three serums which I really love. To correct the discoloration of my skin, I love using my Lancome Dream Tone. I already did a review of this, and I mentioned that in 3 or 4 days, I actually started noticing a lot of differences when using this. For my like acne that pops up that I want gone in like two, three days, I use my Normaderm, this spot treatment. I actually have a written review. There will be a link below the video. For my hands, and I need it right now because my hands are very dry, I currently like using my Dove Pure Pamper Hand Cream. For my face, I kind of keep going back to this cream. For right now, it's Bioderma's Sebum Matte. It's a fluid mattifier for combination to oily skin. Really love it for everyday use, plus using my serums. Also recently I have been using the Rock Hydra Plus for normal to combination skin. Really impressed with it for winter time. Again, in my upcoming skincare routine, you will see me speak more detailed about this. That is that with my skincare products. If I miss something, you will see it in one of my upcoming skincare routine videos. Now the next thing is talking about makeup. For my face, there are basically two primers which I really loved using this year. One of them was a really cheap one. It was called Makeup Academy Undress Your Skin Flawless Skin Primer. I really love this one, and I actually have to write a review of it because I really love it. The other one is MAC Prep and Prime. A lot of you know this is a high-end brand, and it lasts forever, and it's amazing too. For my eyes, the primers which I do love using is Too Faced Eye Primer and the NYX one from that pot, the white one. For my foundation, there's actually a few foundations which I'm going to recommend. It's something between drugstore and to high end. First, I'm going to start with the drugstore. The drugstore products, there are three foundations which I like depending on the season. One is the Bourjois Healthy Mix Foundation, the gel foundation. It's excellent. Another one is the Manhattan Powder Matte Foundation. Love it, excellent for oily skin. Of course, these are all products for combination to oily skin, just because that's my skin type. And last, I can't kind of not mention it, is the Revlon Color Stay Foundation. And now when it comes to the high-end brands, the products which I liked and tend to use the most and really love them is Illamasqua Skin Base. I love it. It's basically like a second skin. And if I want something a little bit more thinner, then for summertime, I kind of want my skin to breathe a little bit more, then I like using my Yves Saint Laurent La Teinte Touche Eclat. So these are my two absolute must-have high-end brands. When it comes to concealers, I still haven't found any of my Holy Grail concealers, but I will mention a few which I do like and I do recommend. So here's a few. One of them is the Glamouflage from Hard Candy. Amazing, long-lasting. If you know how to control it, you can even use it maybe underneath your eyes. The other one is the LA Girl Pro Concealer. I love it. Again, these two are very similar, but this one is a bit more thicker and this one is a bit more thinner and better for the under eye area. A foundation that I like to use as a concealer is the Vichy Dermablend. I don't use this as foundation because I find it to be full coverage and I like to use it as a spot treatment. So kind of I see it like an acne or something, I like to use it to cover acne and spots and so on. So it's really good for concealing and I don't like it as a foundation, but I love it as a concealer. Other thing that I like to use from time to time are my Maron color wheels. One of them is color corrector and the other one is a tattoo concealer. They're for full coverage, so when I have people or myself with a lot of acne, then I kind of like to use that. Another product which I love using sometimes as a foundation and most of the time as a concealer are my Graftopian cream foundations. Excellent. Alright, so when it comes to the eyes, I already mentioned the eye primer, and the next thing I'm going to mention is the eyeshadows. And the eyeshadow which I love are Wet n Wild, but these three colors, I already talked about this, I think it was like the six eyeshadow palettes, but these three colors, my favorite palette out of them is the Silent Treatment. Look at these shades. They are so beautiful. The next one is the Naked 2 palette. I'm not getting three, I'm sorry. I just don't think it's for my skin tone or my eyes. This is, I think, the ideal palette you must have if you have neutral to cool skin and you have dark hair and dark eyes. I really recommend this palette. You will not regret this palette. Also, the other eyeshadows which I really loved this year were from Inglot. Insanely pigmented. I find them equally as good as MAC and they're amazing. Last but not least, you see them using constantly in my videos because I really love them. My Makeup Geek eyeshadows. I love them. They're basically, I define them as the drugstore eyeshadows, but they're better than Wet n Wild and they're basically somewhere along the lines of like Inglot. Another thing I want to mention for the eyes are the bases. If you don't want to get MAC paint pots like for bases, then you should get these Sigma, they're called eyeshadow base. Eyeshadow bases, this is a shade called Provoke. It's a shade you must have. They're amazing, they're eye bases. You can use them kind of like cream. Eyeshadows are just kind of for a base. Another product which I'm loving are the Makeup Geek pigments. When it comes to mascara, I'm very picky about mascara because I basically have very short and very thin, I think they're thin eyelashes. So here's a few which I found to be the best. Like when it comes to drugstore, it's the Rimmel Glam Eyes, one of my favorite eyeshadow, mascaras, not eyeshadow, sorry. So Soap and Glory Thick and Fast. High end would be my Illamasqua mascara. When it comes to blushes, there's many blushes which I like, but here's one of my favorites, which I'm constantly using. And right here, these are my Catrice blushes. And also, I really love my blush from my Sigma Paris palette, shade Peach. This is a really good palette. If you got it, excellent. If not, you missed out quite on a good palette. It's probably one of the better kind of palettes. All right, and a highlighter, which I wanted to mention, from Makeup Academy, it's called Undress Your Skin, really good. And a highlighter which I personally love using is from Makeup Geek. It's actually an eyeshadow, but the shade is called Shimma Shimma. As you can see, I'm hitting pan. I actually have it right here on my cheeks, if I'm not mistaken. As you can see, it's so nice and dewy. For contouring, besides random contouring things, I really like my NYX blush and shade in called Taupe. It's excellent for very fair to light skin tones. If you're darker than that, basically it won't pick up, you won't notice it at all. But this is excellent for lighter skin tones. All right, so when it comes to the eyeliners, the first thing I'll mention, I don't know where it is right now, but it's my Bourjois Kohl pencil. Not only is it great for eyelining your eye, but also for your waterline, and putting it on your waterline is extremely durable and long-lasting. I have very moist and wet eyes, so basically a lot of the Kohl or eye pencils that I apply on my waterline, they basically disappear instantly, but this one is extremely durable. When it comes to gel liners, it's the Makeup Geek shade Immortal, which I use the most. It's a black shade. You can see it on me right now. It takes a little bit to dry, but they're excellent. When it comes to liquid, yet again, it takes a little bit to dry, but I really love the Lush product. It has a lot of fun colors and it's beautiful. And last, the cake liner, which I am in love with, is basically from Illamasqua. It's amazing, long lasting matte finish and does not budge. All right, when it comes to lips, there's actually a few products that I wanna mention. And first, let's talk about the lipsticks. There are a few lipsticks, drugstore and then high end. Drugstore is Gold Rose. I don't think it's in America. I think they're only available in some parts of Europe. Amazing and like super cheap lipstick. They're really good. Other ones are from Wet n Wild, and I really like these. I think they're called Mega Last Collection. They're a bit drying, but they don't kind of crack up your lips or dry. And this shade called Red Velvet, I'm just gonna swatch it for you really quickly. It's one of my favorite shades. Amazing, this whole collection. The last, more let's call it high-end, would be Kryolan. Kryolan lipsticks are also amazing, long-lasting, and fabulous. A few other products that relate to lips would be the Kryolan Lip and Cheek product. Amazing, extremely long-lasting, waterproof. Very similar product to that would be the MUA Lip Liqueur products. And last but not least, a gloss, and the best gloss I've ever used in my life is a Kryolan High Gloss. This is the red shade. I'm actually gonna get some, probably a clear one or something. They're extremely durable, long-lasting, and amazing, and not sick and so on. I have to do a review. I actually did do a review on this. It will be below my video in the info box. When it comes to lashes, I'm kind of always between two lashes. The Red Cherry lashes, they're on my eyes right now, and the Ardell Wispies. These are the double up 2 or 3, which I'm trying recently, and they're amazing. When it comes to brushes, I love my Sigma Beauty makeup brushes. They're amazing. And I do love my e.l.f. Studio Collection brushes. So these are the two which I use the most, and I absolutely love them. But what's really worth by Sigma is their synthetic line. Their synthetic line is absolutely a must-have, and they're amazing. Setting powder, which I'm really loving right now, high-end would be the Illamasqua setting powder and also the Ben Nye setting powders. When it comes to nourishing the lips, I always go to my Carmex. When it comes to the eyebrows, I love my eyebrow pencil, the dual-ended pencil from Sigma Beauty, and especially I love the brow powder in shade medium for me from Sigma 2. Thank you guys so much for watching. Take care and have a happy New Year's, and I'll see you in 2014. Bye!